My name is Timothy. I served in the United States Army. I was a 92 Alpha. My deployment occurred approximately around in 2006. We went to Camp Liberty, Iraq. The scariest thing probably would be the not knowing, the unknown, the quietness, or to go on a briefing and see a lot of red dots where things have happened. I know when I was there, I became a more non-emotional person because I felt like if I got too emotional, I would forget my goal, which was to make it home. So I kind of just learned to shut my emotions completely off. I just became like a non-emotional, null person. And it kind of carried to when I got back home. I was just null and just numb to the emotions with people and didn't care if I hurt people's feelings or anything. But the person that I was when I first came back, I didn't like that person. It was pretty horrible. My loved ones, I stayed distant from them when they were the ones trying to come and love me and talk to me. I didn't want to talk about anything, and I just was shutting everybody completely down. I drank a lot. Like, alcohol is probably one of my biggest things that I like to do. And I didn't know how to turn the off button off. I could just not have an argument with someone and just leave it alone. It was always taken to the next level with me. And I couldn't stand to be around people who would walk up behind me. I hated being people walk up behind me. I hated the 4th of July. I didn't like fireworks. I didn't like anything that had to do with the 4th of July. My first time I got help was when we was in process in the Fort Hood. There weren't necessarily mental health people that worked at the VA, like at the hospital on post. They were just another group of counselors. So I decided to go through there and go through counseling there first. It was very helpful. You know, I got to talk to a couple of my battle buddies that were there. Two of us, actually, me and my other friend, me and him went together. And my counselor would talk to me and just let me know, hey, you have to tell yourself you can do it. You can overcome this. If someone has a problem with you, it's not that serious. If someone steps on your foot, it's okay. Maybe he's having a bad day. I've had to try to learn it and look at it the other way. How would this person feel if I had done it to them? Would they take it this level? Probably not. So I kind of hyped myself up and try to look at it both ways before I started acting out. When I felt like I had it under control, when I felt like I controlled myself, I stopped, which was probably the worst thing. Because once I stopped, I got complacent. I don't have that backup that I had before when I was going to counseling. I don't have anyone encouraging me. I don't have that group that I'm talking to. It's like I'm going back to those bad habits that I had. And it continued on to where I started getting Article 15s. And at that point in time, I had met my wife. And we had went to Korea at that point in time. And then it took my wife to say, babe, you know, you might actually have a problem. You need to go back and get help. That's when I went to the actual mental health facility in Korea. And I started actually getting real help. I went there, you know, and I started talking to the doctor, and I let him know that was going on, and I had other mental health issues as well, and they tried medications, and we tried counseling, and went through a variety of things until I eventually got to where I was comfortable to be the person that I am today. I don't drink anymore. I don't club anymore. I have a family. I have daughters. I can stand for people to walk behind me. And I just, a couple of years ago, was like, I think 2 years ago, I enjoyed my first 4th of July. Really no jumping, no anything. I can just really just enjoy my life and live it. If me and a person get into it, I don't escalate it. I just be like, hey, maybe this guy had a bad day, or maybe it's not worth it. And I think about the outcomes of things now. Before, I just didn't think about the outcomes. I would just react and just go along. But now I think more about life and how I enjoy it and try to live my life to the best. I'm currently going to pursue my bachelor's in psychology, and I would like to get my master's in counseling so I could try to work at the VA and help people as well, to help them through the struggle and let them know that they're not the only one that has been through, because I feel like if someone is there that's a veteran themselves, they can say, hey, this is my struggle. And, hey, I want you to know that you can't come up from where you're at and be something. The first is going to be scary when you want to go get help, but I feel like once you go get help and you start the process and get the ball rolling, it'll be a lot easier once you get started with everything. It's a whole beautiful life that you're missing out on by being a certain way, and I feel like once you get the help that you need and you get medication or you get the counseling that you need, you'll be able to enjoy your life and live it a lot better.